American forces saved lives because it disclosed plans for attacks at Heathrow Airport and Canary Wharf in London. The Guardian also goes with his memoirs, saying that he even drew up plans to attack not only Iran but also Syria, or considered doing so. The Independent has a review of his book. Apparently it even includes a joke about dog poo. The Financial Times, that story we were talking about earlier, Rolls-Royce and the difficulties with that jet engine which grounded the plane in Singapore. And apparently, according to the Daily Mail, 20,000 pensioners a year are being forced to sell their homes to pay for residential care. And the Daily Telegraph says schools are going to have to publish teachers' rates of pay and their sickness records. Well, that's almost enough excitement for one night. So we leave you with good news from the Large Hadron Collider, which, after costs of nearly £3 billion, has finally succeeded in banging together some lead atoms at the speed of light and creating conditions akin to the Big Bang. Here's what they say it might look like. Good night.
Hello, good evening. The last of an overnight severe weather warning for some really heavy showers anywhere between Kent and Dorset will still be in force as Tuesday dawns. Some places could have had 3 inches of rain. So by comparison, things will be somewhat more clement further north, although you won't think it. Given the absence of sunshine and a noticeable northeasterly wind, a really miserable day in prospect with plenty of showers coming into the eastern side of the Pennines and all the way down towards the London area. Something slightly cheerier perhaps as we move out towards the southwest into part of Wales, and indeed, as you'll see in a second, into Northern Ireland as well. But again, it really doesn't do much for the temperatures. 7, 8 or 9 degrees at the very best, and that's a little bit below par for what we would expect at this time of year. There's also a somewhat brighter prospect as we move towards Scotland, but here too, especially across the northeast, there will be showers aplenty, although the winds will be easing down, so perhaps the day not feeling just as raw as it might have done of late. You'll notice that we just keep those showers going on in that northeasterly into eastern areas as we move from Tuesday on into Wednesday. But what is this? Plenty of sunshine to be had, certainly across northern and western parts of the British Isles. There is still the chance of some showers just flirting with the eastern shores of both Scotland and England. You'll also notice that those temperatures really are nothing to write home about at all. For this brief interlude, and I'm afraid that's all it is, we have to thank a little ridge of high pressure which will tumble its way across the British Isles, but lurking out in the wings, yet more wet and windy weather piling into the British Isles for Thursday. Take care. Good night.
A device to get rid of unwanted visitors. Sounds like total genius to me. Dave Gorman has more of your wacky ideas next on BBC Two.
Walking through Delphi is like walking through the story of one of the most important periods in human history.
They were a superstitious, pagan people.
Statues were not just stone. They lived, they breathed, they responded.
Homer even gives directions on how to get to the underworld.
Who gave birth to the modern Western world.
This is huge. This is really at the root of all Western civilization.
The Glory of Greece, next Monday at 9 on BBC Four.
In his lifetime, he was known for being complex and difficult. His friends realized he deliberately hid himself behind a mask of respectability.
I'm on a fantastic journey to look for the origins of life.
A vision of the battlefield quite unlike anything that had ever been seen before.
And 100 years later, these images still have stories to tell.
Comedian Tim Minchin is guest host for Buzzcocks on Thursday at 10. Right now on BBC Two, genius at work.